on 106.5 FM and online. It's the After Five Guest with Wyn Thomas.
Time now for my After Five Guest, Cheryl Baker from The Fizz. Cheryl, thanks for your company this afternoon.
Pleasure, Wyn.
Tonight at the Princess Royal Theatre at 7:30, The Fizz, formerly known as Buck's Fizz, and you're going to be performing there, so it's nice to have your company this afternoon.
We haven't played in Wales for such a long time. And the funny thing is, even though we haven't played in Wales for ages, we're actually playing there tonight and tomorrow. So tonight, as you say, we're at the Princess Royal in Portalbert, and tomorrow we're at Bodlewyddin, so we're in North Wales tomorrow.
Up close and personal with The Fizz, that's the show's called, isn't it?
Yeah, but tonight's show is a proper theatre show.
All
the
right.
Up close and personal tour starts on the 13th of March.
Right.
And that'll be a different show to the one we're doing tonight. Tonight is a proper Fizz show, so it's all the hits. And of course, we've got a new album that's been released today, so we'll be doing a couple of tracks from the new album as well.
You're going to be doing the old songs, songs from the new album. That's absolutely brilliant. So it's been a long tour, isn't it? It's like 18 dates, isn't it? Spread throughout the year.
So the new tour will be 18 dates. We're interspersing those dates with festivals and 80s gigs, 80s weekends and Pride gigs. So it's going to be a busy year for us. And, of course, next year will be our 40th anniversary, so it'll be busier still, hopefully.
Wow, incredible. 40 years. Is that since 1981 when you actually won the Eurovision Song Contest, yeah?
Yes, it is. April the 4th, 1981. So we're almost at 39 years now, and next year will be our 40th.
Wow, it doesn't seem like 40 years, that's for sure.
No, not to me. I mean, it's a miracle because I'm only 36 years old.
I say the same thing every week, yeah. That was a wonderful performance. What do you think now has happened to the Eurovision Song Contest these days? Because we don't seem to get anywhere near winning it now, do we?
No, there's lots of reasons. I think a lot of the reason is that people don't generally like us anymore. But also, I think it's so big now that the competition is harder. And you've got to have not just a good song and a good singer, but you've got to have that little magic something that makes the rest of Europe and Australia, of course, remember your song. You know, there's, like, for instance, with us, it was the skirt ripping, that's for sure.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Generally, the winning song seems to have just that something extra, like the Israeli girl who sang about, was it chickens or hens or something?
Oh, yes.
And the Swedish guy with all these weird things coming out of his hands. And there are all these things that remind you of that song and you want to see it again. So, I mean, our song this year is very good. And I think it's chart-worthy, but whether it's Eurovision-worthy is another matter.
Yeah, so if you want to see some more, then you win the Eurovision Song Contest, yeah?
If you want to see some more, I see what you did there, Wyn. Yes, you do.
So how are you these days? How is Jay and how is Michael?
Fantastic. I mean, you know, Mike, of course, after the coach crash that we had 30-odd years ago, he's made the most amazing recovery, and he's brilliant. As the audience will see tonight when we perform, you know, he's very funny, he's good at what he does, you know. And Jay, obviously more recently, she's been recovering from surgery on her tongue where they discovered she had cancer of the tongue. So she's had 40% of her tongue removed.
Ooh.
And replaced with part of her leg. She's a walking miracle in my eyes, because as a singer, to have your tongue removed and have to learn how to speak again and everything, she's amazing. She's absolutely amazing, so incredibly proud of her. Again, you know, you'll see how good Jay is tonight at the theatre. She's an amazing performer.
Now, Fizz and Buck's Fizz are quite a complicated story with so many different versions of the band out there now. What do you make of all this these days?
It's unfortunate, you know, that there was a big, you know, hoo-ha about the name. And we tried to get the use of the name Buck's Fizz in our title. We went to Trademarks Tribunal and we lost. We couldn't use the name, so that's why we have to go out as The Fizz. And Bobby G's wife, who incidentally was in primary school when we won Eurovision, she owns the name Buck's Fizz. I believe that morally we should all be able to use it, because we all won the Eurovision Song Contest, which gave us our careers. But morals don't come into it when it's the law, you know. There's a saying in Oliver Twist, I believe, the law is an ass. And yes, so there you are.
Who thought the name Buck's Fizz up then? Was it all four of you at the time?
No, we were nothing to do with it. No, the lady who put Buck's Fizz together, Nicola Martin,
yeah,
she was drinking Buck's Fizz at the time when she put the demo down. And so they submitted several songs, and with each song, they had to put a different name down. And so that particular song, she put down Buck's Fizz.
Right.
I mean, it could have been anything. Could have been a cup of tea. It could have been anything. But fortunately, it was Buck's Fizz, yeah.
And then you had a fantastic career afterwards, then, with so many hits afterwards as well, didn't you?
Yes, we did. It was amazing. We had an amazing time. Travelled the world, you know. And to think that here we are, nearly 40 years on, And we've kind of had a reignited career because we've been working anyway for the last maybe 12 or 13 years with Mike and Jay. But we've reignited our recording career with Mike Stock from Stockaken and Waterman.
All right.
Who wanted to do some music with us. As of today, we've released our third album, and we're looking forward to doing another one to celebrate the 40th next year.
Right. So the skirt bit then, was it again something that you thought up on the day, or
we were having a meeting with everyone really, the record label, the production team, the management, the choreographer, and us, and we were all coming up with different ideas. And Jay in particular wanted to wear a short skirt, and I wanted to wear a longer skirt because I've got runner's thighs. I've got really quite muscly thighs. And in the end, it was going round and round in circles. I went, oh, for goodness sake, let's have both, being very flippant about it. But the choreographer went, that's it. On the line, if you want to see some more, we ripped the top skirt off and the little ones underneath. So
marvelous.
It was a moment of genius, and we wouldn't have won the Eurovision without it.
And we were talking in the studio before I started this show, and they were talking about you'd actually been in Coco as well in the Eurovision Song Contest.
Yes, I did Eurovision in 1978 with Coco. Yeah.
Yeah, we were arguing about the date, and I did get that right, thank goodness. It was 1978, yeah.
And that was my childhood dream, so actually we lost in 1978, and to think that I got the chance to do it again and this time win was pretty amazing for me, I must say.
Yeah, so the bad old days disappeared, and you were...
Oh, I see what you did there again.
let's go on to the album, which is called Smoke and Mirrors. Tell us about that. How did that come about?
That was, thankfully, because of Mike Stock. He said, we did the F to Z of Pop, our last new kind of material album, which was released 2 years ago. And he said, okay, let's get in the studio and let's do another album. And actually, while we were doing it, he said, let's do a Christmas one too. So we released a Christmas album. And now we've released Smoke and Mirrors. He's a prolific songwriter. He's written almost every track, except one that my daughter wrote with his son, and one that Jay wrote. And apart from that, they're all Mike Stock songs. And, you know, as I say, he's a prolific songwriter and a genius.
He writes the words on the music.
He actually writes with his son. I think his son writes under a pseudonym. But, yeah, he writes with his son. They're a fantastic duo, a real good double act.
Well, absolutely brilliant. Well, thanks for spending us the time this afternoon for coming on the programme.
It's a pleasure.
And good luck tonight, and also good luck in North Wales as well tomorrow night.
Thank you very much.
Yep.
Thanks.
And we're going to play The World Is Left Behind. We're going to play that track for you now, OK?
I shall be singing that tonight. Thank you, Wynn.
Thank you very much, Gerald. Thanks for being my guest.
Between the hellos and the goodbyes, the promises we made. And looking back, we had the chances. How many did we throw away? But you can't go back just to start it all over. No second chances time. And all I have looking over my shoulder, memory of you, of a world we left behind. And all I have looking over my shoulder is just a memory of you, of a world we left behind. We can recall our favorite places like it was yesterday. Slowly drift away. No matter how you fight the changes, we'll never be the same again. But you can't go back just to start it all over. No second chances time. And all I have looking over my shoulder. things to start in an omen. No second chance is time.
It's time.
And all I have looking over my shoulder.